Isayoi Sakamaki is a young boy who is bored with his whole lifestyle he has on Earth. The boy has special abilities beyond anyone's imagination, and living alongside real humans is not so interesting for him. There are other kids like him too. Asuka, a rich lord's daughter who has the ability to command everyone around her to do whatever she wants them to. And Kasukabe, who has a range of special powers, the main one being she can talk to animals. These three special children are just too tired of their normal yet special life on Earth and dream of something special. One day, the three of them receive a mysterious letter inviting them to the land of Little Garden. As soon as they finish reading the letter, they are instantly transported to an unknown world. The three superhumans fall from the sky and land directly in a nearby lake. Almost immediately, they manage to swim out of the lake and acquaint themselves with each other. The three suddenly notice that a weird-looking rabbit-human girl is spying on them. The special kids use their powers to immediately subdue the girl, who introduces herself as Black Rabbit. Black Rabbit finally introduces them to the world that they were invited to. The world was called Little Garden, and she was one of the servants of the creator of that place. Little Garden, as she explains, is a large casino world where beings ranging from puny humans to literal gods can come and play with each other. They host games called gift games, where participants can wager anything from their pride to their own lives in return for whatever they want with the host. She explains that rabbits like her are the enforcers of Little Garden who make sure that every game is fair and square and no cheating is involved. She has a heightened sense of abilities connected to the central system of Little Garden, which helps her enforce the rules. The world of Little Garden has many country-like communities that rule over different parts of the world. These communities are responsible for hosting gift games that people, as well as communities, can take part in. Black Rabbit is also part of one of these communities and offers to let them in if they can beat her in a game. Isayoi, Asuka, and Kasukabe are intrigued by the idea of this world, which is so different from their own. They decide to take on the challenge. The game is simple. If they can find the face card in a deck in one try, they win. For now, since they don't have anything else to wager, Black Rabbit tells them to wager their pride. She doesn't know, however, that besides having special powers, the children are also super smart. Isayoi simply memorizes the position of all cards and slams his hand on the desk to reveal the card for others while he grabs one for himself as well. Since they didn't break any rule, Black Rabbit is forced to acknowledge her defeat. As promised, Black Rabbit guides the trio back to her rural village in the east. However, she gets distracted, during which Isayoi slips away, hoping to find the edge of Little Garden. Outside the gates of the village, a young boy named Jin, the master of Black Rabbit's small community, waits for the new recruits that Black Rabbit had brought for them. She hands over the responsibility of Asuka and Kasukabe to him and rushes back to get Isayoi. She is worried. Isayoi was so cocky, he could have probably challenged a god for a gift game by now. Little Garden turns out to be a flat earther's paradise, and Isayoi manages to get to the edge of the world. Just as Black Rabbit reaches him and believes that perhaps the boy hadn't been so rash as she believed, a huge water dragon, the god of water, emerges from the waterfall. Isayoi had challenged this god to a duel gift game. Elsewhere, Jin takes Asuka and Kasukabe inside Little Garden's actual premises for the first time. The place is a bustling city filled with various kinds of creatures. The trio sits down to get some tea at a restaurant. Just then, they are confronted by Galdo Gaspar, a beast man who is also the leader of a community named Forest Garo. The man is as cocky as Isayoi, if not more, and ignores Jin altogether, asking the girls to join his community instead. Back at the waterfall, surprisingly, it doesn't even take 2 minutes for Isayoi to defeat the literal god of the water, and in return for winning the gift game, they are gifted with a big water tree sapling. This meant that they no longer needed to pay for water. Isayoi then demands to know the actual reason why the three of them were transported to this world. Having no choice, Black Rabbit reveals how their community was forced to become one of the weakest when they were basically blackmailed into playing a gift game with one of the demon lords. The demon lord had taken their name and banner, resulting in the community becoming one of the most disgraced ones in all of Little Garden. This made all the other members of the community leave, and now all they had left was Jin and 120 other children remaining in the community. In the restaurant, Galdo is using this same information to berate Jin's no-name community and tries to lure the two powerful girls into his community. He boasts that his community had gathered several hundred banners and was the most powerful community on the east side. Asuka gets suspicious of Galdo's claim that his community has won all gift games. Usually, demon lords were the only ones powerful enough to win such games in succession, and Galdo wasn't one. She uses her powers and commands him to reveal how he was winning, and they find out that Galdo had been kidnapping women and children from other communities before the games so that they would surrender without much of a fight. However, the madman didn't return the hostages either. He had just killed the hostages on the day that he had captured them. This angers the two girls, who immediately challenge him to a duel gift game the next day. After Black Rabbit and Izuyoi return to Little Garden and reunite with the group, Jin takes them all to get their powers appraised. On their way, the group also realizes that each of the special children were from different timelines on Earth. Jin takes them to a demon lord that lives in the locality, Shiroyasha, from the Thousand Eyes, an excessively large and widespread trade community in Little Garden. Despite being a demon lord, however, Shiroyasha was more on the peace-loving side and had established himself as the guardian of the east side. He explains to them about the seven levels of Little Garden. Each level had different communities living there based on their power. No-name communities lived on the outskirts of the seventh level. Before Shiroyasha can appraise their gifts, the special kids challenge him to a gift game. However, Izuyoi cheekily makes sure that the game is a challenge game rather than a duel. Shiroyasha challenges them to ride a griffin through the gates presented before them without falling. The task is especially difficult as the immense speed would render anyone unconscious and make them fall. Kasukabe decides to take on the challenge, and somehow successfully manages to complete it. It is then revealed that she gets her powers from the wooden pendant around her neck, given to her by her father. The artifact not only allowed her to talk to animals, but also take the abilities of animals she had befriended. Happy with the games being completed, Shiroyasha hands each of them some gift cards that can help them store their gifts and also appraise them. Kasukabe has the ability to control and use other animals' powers. Asuka can command anyone to do anything. And finally, Izuyoi's powers are, well, unknown. Jin and Black Rabbit then take the special children to the no-name community's base, which has been completely decimated by the Demon Lord after winning their banner gift game. The game had taken place only a few years ago, but the destruction appears to look like it had been going on for around 200 years or more. The group heads to the center of the river that has now dried up. Using the water sapling that Izuyoi had won earlier, they plant a tree there that gives them an endless supply of water. That same night, Galdo's subordinates infiltrate the no-name's territory. They plan on taking the children captive, like Galdo always does, but this time, Izuyoi catches them snooping around. The subordinates claim that they are only working for Galdo, as he has their children and women held captive. So Izuyoi reveals that their captives were all dead already. He claims that they no longer needed to fear though, as Jin, the master of the no-name's community, would free them all from the demon lords that terrorized Little Garden. When the group leaves, Jin pulls him aside to warn him that what he said would just attract unnecessary attention to their already weak community. Izuyoi reasons that, although the demon lords and other communities would attack them, the plan would gain them fame, and communities who would be against the demon lords would join them. Right now, they lacked members, and that is exactly what this strategy would bring them. During their conversation, Jin reveals the powers of demon lords. One such lord had even managed to enslave their strongest member. The member was a demon lord herself, but having lost herself to the other lord's community, was now being wagered as a prize in a gift game. Jin requests Izuyoi to win the game so that they could retrieve back their member. Izuyoi agrees, but on one condition. They first had to defeat Galdo in the game the next day. If not, he would leave the community instead. That night, a strange vampire arrives at Galdo's mansion and gives him some more power. She wants the no-name to face the monster that she had created. The next day, all of them are brought to Galdo's residence, which appears to be surrounded by some sort of a magical forest. Outside the residence, they are acquainted with the rules of the gift game. To win, they had to defeat Galdo, but couldn't use their powers on him to do so. Instead, a weapon would appear during the fight, which had to be used to defeat him. Asuka, Kasukabe, and Jin head into the mansion and are confronted by Galdo, who is now fully converted into a massive white demon tiger. Jin realizes that the whole area was surrounded by demonic and vampiric magic, and suspects that someone else was involved with all of this. The weapon that was to be used to defeat Galdo appears as well, and Kasukabe charges into battle. She gets severely injured, however, as in brute strength, Galdo was far superior to her. Asuka then lures Galdo into the forest and realizes a loophole in the rules. She couldn't use her powers on Galdo to defeat him, but she could use them on other things. She commands the forest to restrain Galdo and also commands the sword itself to give her all its strength, using which she slays the demon. The gift game was won. With Galdo defeated, all of his slaves are freed from his community, and before them, Jin vows that he will defeat all the demon lords. While Kasukabe continues to recover, Black Rabbit discusses with Izayoi their next step to rescue Letitia, the same demon lord who was once part of their community. Their conversation is suddenly interrupted by the same vampire who assisted Galdo. The vampire was none other than Letitia herself. She apologizes for causing them trouble, as she only wished to know the extent of the children's powers. After watching them defeat Galdo, she had concluded that their gifts were too unrefined to manage the community and wants Black Rabbit to disband it. They explained that they were trying to get her back using the gift game that was being hosted soon, but Letitia informs them that the game had been cancelled. Elsewhere, the leader of the Perseus community, Luis Perseus, comes to Shiroyasha and announces that he had cancelled the game because he had found a suitable buyer for Letitia instead. Shiroyasha is angered by this, but can do nothing because of the demon that Luis has in his possession, the Gorgon. The no-names go to talk to Luis to convince him somehow to hand back Letitia to them. The man, however, is super pretentious and perverted. He proposes that if Black Rabbit submits herself instead of Letitia, he might consider returning her back to the no-names community. Black Rabbit almost considers doing as he pleases, but Izayoi has other ideas. He goes ahead and defeats the two feared monsters, Kraken and Greye, who give him the special artifacts with whose help he could challenge anyone to a gift game, forcing them to accept. With these gifts, they head straight to Luis and challenge him to the game. Hope you enjoyed part 1. If this video gets 500 likes, I will continue to part 2. Thanks for watching.